We must pursue heavenly modes of living, kingdom living. That is what makes us different. For it is what the world needs ever more. It is what, what we should be known as followers of Jesus. It is what the church gathered with God to be compelled to live out. This is what Scripture says about Matthew 7:20. You will know them by their John 13:35. This is how everyone will know you are my disciples when you love each other. See, apparently, as followers of Jesus, we have a mode of living, a kingdom and heavenly mode, and by that mode we shall be known. What then shall we do? If we are so keenly aware of this mode of living, where do we go from such? I believe there are some human characteristics to the kingdom or heavenly mode living kind of person. The first, I believe it begins with having compassionate heart. The next, does your heart break when you see injustice in the world? If it does not, then ask yourself why. Why am I so indifferent? Why am I so unaffected? We weep for the hungry, the poor, the foreigner, the refugee, the prisoner. And there are actual clinical studies that demonstrate that crying and weeping out during these emotions in stressful or grieving situations. It can help to physically grieve our eyes. But if one finds it difficult to cry or to weep, there may be a reason. Research says that it might be related to mental health, to feelings of emptiness, of apathy, repressed emotions, social problems, and such a way of living can have adverse health effects. A frequent emotional or physical can also create numbness or immune emotions and make it difficult to fight. But friends, we need to learn. Jesus wept three times in fact. John 11:35 says that Jesus began to cry after hearing that Lazarus had died, and again in verse 38 became deeply disturbed again and began to weep. In John 19:41 it says, as Jesus came to the city and observed it, he wept more.
As well, are you interested in knowing the future, the truth of things? Are you willing to read, research, do the academic work, become more educated, more informed about the world? Well, I have some pedagogy to assist your learning today. I spent the last 10 days or so researching, studying, doing the academic work around the first place. I share some of my words with you. You've heard before, in 1620, the Mayflower set sail with 102 passengers, known to us as pilgrims. People who were extremely literalists of the Bible, radical Protestants, seeking religious freedom from the Church of England, the Anglicans. English exiles who were living in Dutch Republic at the time. Fair to say, England did not send them back. They arrived and settled in Plymouth Rock, and contrary to popular belief, Jamestown, which was founded in 1607, was the first established colony of Europeans, not Plymouth Rock, which was founded in 1620. It's the first first candidate, first vice candidate in bringing America's national imagination. There are only a few details about the first Thanksgiving in Union Bank for Jesus, the writings. It was known to Abraham as the first Christian people coming in. It was just a case, and that was the choice that he had a long time on. He was just about to recognize him.
Thank you.
to over injustice. What good is it to have the mentality of injustice if we're not willing to talk this country? What good is it to be emotionally and mentally prepared if our bodies do not activate and move? We must get into the game, into the action, to participate in the healing and reconciling of this world, to serve in organizations, churches, ministries, systems that are reclaiming the kingdom of heaven, who are living like heaven is already here, so they go out and that there's a bias in the midst of it all. We make the protests and rallies and events and boldly declare liberation is here, freedom is here, healing is here, reconciliation. For all our kingdom of God who are watching us. For all that just may be worthy eyes of the divine, worthy of a warm meal, worthy of a fresh cup of water, worthy of a basic system. For all our free who they are beautiful, wonderful being, with a beautiful color of skin, a beautiful hair, body, personality, gifts, passions. They're all made in the beautiful image of the divine. It is our holy ancestry that compels us to be made. We must have open souls. What do I mean by this? We are too late to receive things either open or closed. Young people, listen to what scripture says. Listen to advice and accept instruction that you might grow wise in the future. Proverbs 19:20. Mature people in the room, listen to this scripture and say good things to each other, pray for each other, so that you may feel the prayer of the righteous person is powerful in what they need to do to find it. The point is this, the kingdom mode of living is open to receive at all times, open to others' wisdom, open to advice, open to a new idea, open to allowing God's power and work go beyond our human limitations, open to believing that God is greater than our traditions, greater than our beliefs, greater than our styles and preferences. We must allow the will of God to move and to take us. Are you open to such a God like that? And lastly, do you have a generous spirit? Scripture says, this is how we know love. Jesus laid down his life for us, and we ought to lay down our lives for our brothers and sisters. So, if someone has material possessions and he's a brother or sister in need, but refuses to help, how can the love of God dwell in a person like that? Little children, it's not love that words are speaking, but we have to be in truth. This is how we will know that we belong to the truth and we minister our hearts. The generosity is about giving to those who are in need, especially if you have married material possessions, especially if you have disposable income. This is how we will know that we belong to God. If we can get those signs that allow us to prove that we are kingdom mode kind of people. It's not just about being generous with our possessions and money, but it's also to be generous with our time, with our talents, with our gifts, with our forgiveness, generous with our patience, generous with our trust, and our belief in God. My friend, this is a new characteristic. It changes the world. As we would live this way, our world in our world, our community. Who needs generosity, compassion, and faith in action, our community, our college kids, students, our marriages, our parents, our communities, our schools, our neighborhoods, our churches, our world. We shall reject the most of this difficult way. Ignorant mind, passive body, sin against soul, and selfish people. We reject the general doctrine of oppression. We are thinking for those times we belong to the creator and creator and sustainer, because we are children of Yahweh. wonderful pastor.